Good evening and welcome to our event tonight. I'm Dale Bonds, a representative with the Juice Plus Company. Almost every night of the week, all over the globe, our company sponsors public events just like this one, as we inspire healthy living around the world and introduce people to our incredible business. As we get started, I'm going to mute everyone to eliminate background noise. Let me take a minute to share why I got involved with Juice Plus. I am a Hurricane Katrina survivor. I had no idea what kind of pestilence I was returning to. So when my sister introduced the product to me, I thought, well, I certainly need more fruits and vegetables in my diet. And I need to enhance my immune system to prepare me for what might be waiting for me back in New Orleans. As a postmenopausal woman, I was struggling with brittle nails and hair. Within 2 weeks, I started noticing a difference in that regard and have never looked back. I had more energy and my immune system became so much stronger. Today, I wouldn't be a day without it. Since I was noticing so many good things, I started sharing with folks as they came back to New Orleans to rebuild their homes and lives. For me, it has been a great way to help replenish a wardrobe lost after the storm and a good supplement to my retirement income that gives me that extra spending change every woman should have. Tonight, we'll give you an overview of our products and just a snapshot of what we do as a company and as individuals with very busy lives. You or someone you know may be looking for a new opportunity, a way to earn more income, or possibly help a family member get well. What we share with you this evening will touch on each of those aspects. We'll start off this evening with Ro Melnikov, our area team leader, who will tell you why she joined our business and what it can offer you. And now, here's Ro.
Thanks, Dale, for that introduction. Let me tell you a little about my own story. Has anyone ever had their significant other break up with them? Can you imagine that my former husband said to me, "You're too sick for me to stay with you. I want a divorce." It was painful, and I didn't know what was worse for me, me going through my health challenges or the divorce. We divorced in 1989. Let me tell you about myself. I'm formerly an elementary teacher and an adjunct college professor. But today I'm with the incredible Juice Plus Company. I resigned from teaching to join them in a mission to inspire healthy living over 22 years ago. Why, you might say, would I leave my tenure, my pension, and a nice salary behind to join a marketing company when I had no experience in marketing? Well, my story started in a hospital bed. The doctors were trying to figure out how to use gravity to assist in getting the water out of my legs without having to lie me down, because it would result in excruciating pain from the pleurisy in my chest. You see, my kidneys were failing secondary to the systemic lupus, which I was diagnosed with when I was 22 in college. I suffered with arthritis, liver involvement, bowel problems, and I was always tired and lethargic. I took tons of medicines and vitamins to no avail. I changed my diet, but I still had flares. Adding the Juice Plus products, concentrated fruits, vegetables, and berry powders in capsules, made a tremendous difference in my health. It not only lowered the inflammation in my body, but it also contributed to a healthier immune system, improved my hair, skin, and energy, and gave me so many other health benefits. It also acted as a catalyst, encouraging me to make other lifestyle changes. I actually started to crave more fruits and vegetables. Today, I can sit before you and God and say that I've been symptom-free with no medications, but with lots of energy and vitality for the past 20 plus years. I also might add, I married my divorce attorney, and we have two healthy young men. Tyler, 23, and Dustin, 18. Imagine that after being told by medical doctors that I would never even conceive. I, at the age of 37, then 41, had those babies. I know you're probably trying to do the numbers. Yes, I'm 60 years old. Now, with getting results like that, you can imagine my passion and great desire to pay it forward. Now, at this time, I would like to introduce our featured speaker. Matt Brown, MD, is a practicing physician in Boone, North Carolina, specializing in internal medicine. His professional background includes the following: undergraduate degree from Emory University, Doctor of Medicine from the Medical College of Georgia. He has conducted both basic and clinical research and has co-authored a number of publications in respected medical journals. He is board certified and recertified in internal medicine and currently does online health consulting focusing on digestion, as well as working full-time in a hospital setting as what is now known as a hospitalist. Dr. Brown was head of the internal medicine clinic for the U.S. Naval Hospital in Naples, Italy for 3 years and served 2 years as the head of the clinical investigation branch of the U.S. Naval Medical Research Unit in Cairo, Egypt. He received the Army Commendation Medal for outstanding service in coordinating medical support for the Joint Task Force cleanup operation of the Yellowstone National Fires in 1988. Over the last 10 years, in his passionate and humorous style, Dr. Matt has been sharing with audiences from the East to the West Coast of North America and Hawaii why he believes, what he believes are the keys to health and longevity, to healing and physical wellness. Well, before you get started, Dr. Brown, I'd like to thank you for supporting our nation so we enjoy freedoms unimaginable in other countries. We're also honored to have someone of your caliber be with us tonight. So without further ado, Dr. Matt Brown.
All right. Well, thanks, Ro, and thanks, Dale, for getting the call started. And it's a privilege to be here this evening and share with y'all. And everybody hear me okay?
Yes.
Okay. Well, my journey with Juice Plus started back in 2006. I was a cycler. I was looking for the edge on nutrition, and a homeschooling mom had been after me for about a year and a half to look at the research behind Juice Plus. But as a skeptical physician, I, like so many of my colleagues, dismissed it outright, even though she was forwarding me links to actual specific research studies. I just dismissed it until I actually came across one of those published studies at my medical meeting at the American College of Sports Medicine in Denver, Colorado in 2006. So, you know, it was kind of cool to be at a meeting where I felt at home, where nutrition was being promoted, where lifestyle and exercise was being treated literally as medicine. And in that context, being able to see a Juice Plus study being done by actually one of the best known exercise physiologists in the college. So you have to understand that the world comes to the American College of Sports Medicine's annual meeting. So the world of sport is there to look at the data that's being published. And there is a Juice Plus study in athletes and looking at an oxidative stress marker. And that really got my attention. So I come back home from the meeting and I'm thinking, what am I going to do with my diet, with my supplements? Because I was probably taking somewhere around 20 vitamin pills, but you know, I was married to that and I couldn't just leave it behind. So I kind of dawdled over the summer. This was in May, dawdled over the summer. And really by, September that I went to a medical meeting hosted by an alternative group of physicians, a couple hours away. And the physician who spoke on nutrition in a way that I'd never heard it before. And you have to understand that physicians are not educated on nutrition. That cannot be emphasized enough. So when people talk about The idea of discussing your dietary habits with your doctor and your supplements with your doctor, beware, because we don't get training in this kind of area. So I, like so many other doctors I know, and medical students are still in the same boat, they're not getting training. I mean, my whole experience and exposure to nutrition came from my mother and my grandmother, and it really didn't have anything to do with what I learned in medical school, because I got a 1-hour course that I chose to skip on nutrition. So you just have to understand that's the context in which doctors are getting trained. And the emphasis is not changing in for the most part, not at least through the medical schools that I know of. So I come back from this meeting, I'm kind of like, wow, this is curious, but married still until September. So I'm attending this meeting, and this doctor is speaking on nutrition in a way that I've never heard it stated before. In fact, I'm beginning to understand that nutrition has a role in her practice that I've never been familiar with. And so I left that meeting and I said, wow, you know, let me go back and let me read the book that she's quoting from. It was called Ultra Metabolism by Dr. Mark Hyman. And so it was a pretty well-known book at the time. And so interestingly enough, the first 10 chapters of that book talked about how fruits and vegetables, how nutrition can literally turn on good genes and turn off bad genes. What he called the idea of nutrigenomics. And I think nowadays it's way more embraced than it was then. And I said to myself, okay, well, if what she's saying is true, I need to go back and revisit the study that I'd seen at ACSM. And I need to go and pull some of these other studies that are supporting the research, that are supporting Juice Plus. And so I did. And I was blown away. And I'll never forget seeing a DVD by Dr. Rick DuBois. And that DVD, in that DVD, he said, you know, the thing about Juice Plus is you're known by the company you keep. And the company that Juice Plus keeps was top quality universities throughout the U.S. and around the world. And that research is only getting better since I joined the company, which was in, again, October 2006. So without further ado, I said to myself, okay, I'm going to get myself on Juice Plus based on the research, based on the fact that I'm looking for the edge as a competitive cycler. And I did. And my family did. And we threw away about $600 or $700 worth of vitamins, vitamin pills. And we became the healthy, happy brown household. In fact, my oldest, I think it was one of my sons, basically made a message on our phone. We were a homeschooling family, and he made a message on our phone recorder that kind of was sarcastic, and he goes, welcome, you know, we're not here right now. You've reached the healthy, happy brown household. We're not here right now. Call us back. But the idea being that there's been this change in what we were doing, and Juice Plus for us was truly a catalyst for so many changes in our diet. And indeed, I did see, just like Ro has stated, I think everybody that gets on Juice Plus seems to have this experience of, wow, I really crave this stuff. You know, my then 8-year-old, the youngest of 4, came up to me in a meeting that we were at, and he sheepishly asked, you know, Dad, what do you want, Joel? Can I have one more serving of salad? That was going to be his third serving. So it was really cool that I was seeing my kids who have nobody to impress make changes. And, you know, I had a 16 and an 18-year-old. And for them, it's a hard age, and they're not likely to make changes because dad and mom say so. There's got to be something else. So their taste buds changed. So we changed as a family. And what I began to see for me personally was a change in my athletic performance and my recovery. And I have a cycling buddy who went through the same. He started Juice Plus at the same time. He was hypertensive. He'd been hypertensive for years, and he really did not want to be on a blood pressure medication as a competitive cyclist. And so I introduced Juice Plus to him. Within a very short period of time, he came off blood pressure medication. And what I noticed and what we noticed together was this remarkable recovery. And within 6 weeks of starting Juice Plus, we were both on a ride together. And we had done a 50-mile ride 2 days earlier. And we were climbing up one of the steepest rides in our area that was made famous by Lance Armstrong. And so we're climbing this steep climb. And we're looking over. And, you know, I'm looking at him. He's looking at me. And he's smirking. And I'm like, you think what I'm thinking? Yeah, I'm not sore. And it's amazing that when you're flooding your body with the number of phytonutrients that are found in Juice Plus, it's going to impact every cell in your body because we are what we eat. And I think that's convincingly shown. I think that's a common saying, but it's true. So that was the start for me. And what I said to myself was, wow, I've experienced a powerful thing, but what's good for the goose is good for the gander. And for me, I had a practice of 1,500, 2,000 patients, and I was convinced at that point that Juice Plus is what I needed to share with my patients. And I was also struggling at the time financially because I wanted to spend more time with my patients than insurance would allow me to do. So I was thinking to myself, is there a possibility that I could create a business that would allow me to design my practice the way I want to? Is there this extra income stream that potentially allows me to separate myself from the reimbursement that is so shrinking? And so I did. I became a rep at that point. And I just basically, when the homeschooling mom came met me and her national marketing director met me to sign me up for the business, they said, I was like, don't tell me anything else. I don't need any other information. You tell me where to sign on the bottom line, because this, I believe, is what I need to be sharing with my patients. That's enough. And and they were like, well, what's your goal? And I was like, I want enough money to be able to practice the way I want to. I want this to be an income stream for me that absolutely untethers me from the traditional insurance reimbursement plan. So fast forward to 2014. Unfortunately, although I had built a great Juice Plus business, it was not enough to keep me out of financial turmoil as a practitioner. And actually, at that point, I did actually have to close my doors, and that's when I became a hospitalist. Well, along the way, though, I had the privilege of seeing so many patients benefit from Juice Plus. I saw myself as a clinician seeing improvements in markers of inflammation. I saw myself improvements in weight and energy and skin. So what Rose shares, what Dale shares, what so many people have experienced in the Juice Plus, in their Juice Plus experience, it's absolutely solid. And as I've spoken around the country and in Canada, Hawaii, I've had people come up to me and just share their story. I've had mind-boggling stories. And Ro, your story is up there at the top for sure. But I would say that this makes sense. And let me shift gears here. I'll share you two things with you that have happened to me since I started taking Juice Plus. So I faced, I started having chest discomfort at the end of 2010, was a competitive cycler. In January of 2011, I started having discomfort that I knew was related to my heart. And you have to understand at that point, I was a vegan. I was actually a practicing not eating any meat, a low fat, being as conscious as I could about my diet, and still something happened. Well, what was it? I had a heart catheterization finally. It had a 95% blockage in the top part of, for me, the biggest artery of my heart, called the left anterior descending artery, and it's what's called the widowmaker. And so the cardiologist looked at that, the heart catheterization, and was pretty amazed that I had no other disease, no other blockages, no nothing. In fact, he kind of laughed when he did the heart catheterization. He said, "Man, I'm going to help you today. You're going to be better." And after he put that stent in, I was like, I couldn't believe it. My chest was actually empty feeling, because I've been having resting chest discomfort. Well, my wife comes in, she's asking, now Dr. Chang, you don't know my husband, but he's going to do exactly what he wants to do unless you tell him that he can't do certain things. And Dr. Chang said, he can do anything he wants to. His arteries are wide open. And, I am convinced that what kept my other arteries open, what allowed my body, my heart to make collaterals through, was the nutrition that I was getting through food, but also the consistency of what Juice Plus was putting into my body every day. And there's research. We've got 9 studies that support cardiovascular health. So we have evidence that supports my contention that if I was not on Juice Plus, I think I probably would have suffered a major heart attack. Mm. I had no heart damage. So I fast forward, bumpy, stressful time for me, between about 2011 and 2014, when I had to finally close my practice. And after that, became a very busy hospitalist, continued to travel and speak and be very busy. Well, in 2016, I faced the next health challenge as I started having a problem with my right eye. And that was what's called uveitis, and I lost functional vision in my eye. That got better after 3 months, and then I started having gut problems. And I wound up with the diagnosis of Crohn's disease. And it wasn't mild Crohn's disease, it was moderate to severe. And so in February of this year, I was placed on a combination of prednisone and a drug called Humira, which I'm sure you've seen the commercials for. Yeah. Well, there's some warnings about Humira. If you'll watch at the end of the commercial, it says serious and even life-threatening conditions can occur as a result of being on Humira. And so I had turned off prednisone in May, and subsequently, I had taken the dose of Humira, and about a week later, I wound up with a neck infection. I wound up with a sore throat that actually turned into an abscess, spread into my neck, and threatened to close my airway off. And I was hospitalized for 6 days and subsequently had to have a PICC line put in my arm and 2 more weeks of antibiotics. And, you know, you might say to yourself, well, wow, you know, how'd all that happen? You know, gang, I really can't say, because I mean, as far as being mindful about nutrition, mindful about lifestyle, I can say I was pretty mindful. Now, genes were not in my favor because my father has Crohn's disease as well, and he got diagnosed with it at my age. But here's what's cool, is since being on it, with moderate to severe Crohn's, I have tapered off. I was able to taper off prednisone over 3 months with moderate to severe Crohn's. And you need to understand, that's extremely unusual. The cards were stacked way against me to come off prednisone within a year or two. So I rapidly came off. And the second thing is, Humira may have given me a clinical response, but I stopped Humira 6 weeks, almost 2 months ago now. And the exciting thing is, I have absolutely no symptoms. And so I really feel like, you know, each one of us is going to face challenges, health challenges, along our journey. And this is a journey. This is not a destination. And we're not perfect. You know, the challenges are going to happen. The fact is, though, what each one of us has the privilege to do is to stack the deck in our favor for how we get through a condition. Or something that happens in life, a stressful event. And so that's where I think nutrition plays such an essential role. And I think this is where Juice Plus is so powerfully filling in the gap. Okay, let me just take a few minutes here and explain to you why I believe Juice Plus is so essential to health. And it has to do with this latest research that's coming out on the human microbiome. You see, we're not just us. Each one of us sitting on this call tonight think, well, yeah, I'm me. Well, no, actually, you're not. You're actually a combination of about 1,000 strains of bacteria that live in and on you, and that comprises what's called now the human microbiome. And most of that lives in the intestinal tract. You know, gang, I've been speaking on this for, almost 4 years now, and I got interested in it because of Juice Plus. Because I was saying to myself in my practice, how in the world can a diabetic's blood sugar improve this fast? It's not possible based on human cellular physiology. Something else is going on. I couldn't explain it. I couldn't explain why blood pressure changes were occurring so fast. And I couldn't explain how the studies were achieving results so quickly. So I was saying to myself, you know, there's got to be an intermediary here that's signaling human cells. And I started thinking about my research in the GI tract in Egypt. And I said, it's got to be bacteria. And so I actually asked Dr. Susan Percival, who's done one of our studies. She's a leading nutritional immunologist from the University of Florida. I asked Dr. Percival, you know, what she felt like was the mechanism by which Juice Plus was having these kinds of effects in her study and in general. And I said, I think that it's bacteria. I think it's our gut flora that is mediating. We're feeding our gut flora. They're changing their profile, and they're influencing our immune system, our digestion, but principally our immune system. And from that, we're realigning, and we're protecting, and we're balancing. She said, absolutely. And so I'll tell you right now that just sparked my excitement about this whole area. Well, about 3 years ago in the New England Journal of Medicine, there was a very compelling article talking about a group of people who were assigned, and they were vegans, assigned to eat a steak. And there was another group of people that were assigned to eat a steak that were just omnivores. They ate an average diet. Well, what they found in this study was fascinating. They found that the group of vegans that ate the steak, that they did not have a substance that showed up in their bloodstream called TMAO, trimethylamine oxide. The group that was eating a regular diet, they ate the steak and they had that TMAO show up. Well, here's the cool part of this. Researchers at Cleveland Clinic took an antibiotic and gave it to the omnivores, refed them a steak, and guess what? TMAO did not show up in the bloodstream. The antibiotic had killed off most of their gut flora, and that what metabolized was the standard steak without this harmful substance. What that showed the researchers was that bacteria are essential to metabolizing our food, creating substances that are both beneficial and harmful. And this is just the start of things. I mean, this whole area has blown wide open. And it's so amazing that that now what we know is that the bacteria in an onion, principally in your gut, control your metabolic profile. They literally increase your risk of diabetes or they decrease your risk. And this is why I tell people, do not eat sugar substitutes. Do not eat aspartame, sucralose, saccharin, because what's happening is they actually kill your good bacteria. And a group of Israeli researchers published their data in a top medical journal. And what they showed was you're going to increase your risk of diabetes and metabolic syndrome by putting these sugar substitutes in your body. Now, just came out a few days ago that actually rates of obesity go up eating. The people who consistently eat sugar substitutes, they gain more weight. And so this is just a slice of what we know about the microbiome and how critical it is to feed not just your body, but the intestinal microbiome. So in my mind, Juice Plus is supporting this microbiome. And through that, we're seeing all these amazing changes in our body. And it happens relatively fast. So this is another whole piece to this puzzle. And I'll tell you, I was so excited about this research that I asked Manfred Lamprecht and I asked Randy Matthews at the company. I said, guys, we have got to do a Juice Plus study that supports my contention that Juice Plus is a powerful prebiotic. It's modifying and enhancing our microbiome. And they have. So the University of Memphis took on this study and they are doing this in nurses. And I'm super excited about what's going to come out of that study. I think it's going to be compelling. All right, guys, I know my time is up, so I'm going to stop there.